Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the internet. This is Rendog coming at you from Mob Castle in this Let's Play Minecraft Survival series. In the previous episode, we were finishing off the entrance to the Nether Portal Temple after many years of neglect. And in this episode, my friends, we are moving over to another project that we are trying to finish off for season number 4. And that is the Victorian Greenhouse Auto Farm Facility. We've also got a ton of amazing things to talk about today, guys. So I want you to sit back and relax. I want you to get a tasty-ass beverage, a crunchy-ass snack. It is time to play some Minecraft Survival, and I am super excited. It's a beautiful day in London. Once again, the sun is shining through my window on my face. I've just put in a laundry into the machine. Give me one second. And hopefully that laundry is going to be finished by the end of this episode, because let me tell you something, guys, I don't have any clean clothes at the moment in real life. And that's because I've had a crazy week, a crazy busy week. In fact, I don't think I've ever worked this hard in my entire life for the last 7 days or so. It has been absolutely mental. And that is, of course, because I've got some super exciting news to share with you guys today. For those of you guys who are perhaps not following my channel very well or haven't seen the news recently, I've got something absolutely amazing to share with you today. Now, I'm here at Mob Castle. I'm doing a bit of grinding. I've been grinding now for about 30 minutes or so. Picked up a few levels. We're on level 33 right now. And that is, of course, because we are trying to create some new epic gear for us in the survival series. And yeah, we can head over to the Wizard's Tower now to enchant a few more books and try and get some more epic enchants going. But while I'm doing that, my friends, I want to start talking to you guys, because I've got so much to talk about in today's episode. It's just absolutely crazy. Firstly, I want to say a massive welcome to all of the new cyberdogs who have joined this channel over the last 10 days. It has been crazy, my friends. The Rendog channel has been going absolutely bananas this week. We have picked up so many subscribers. It's actually just blown my mind right now. I wake up every morning and I log into YouTube. I'm like, damn, check how many more people have joined us. It's absolutely mental. And I just want to welcome all of you new guys out there to my Minecraft survival world. This is episode 388. This series has been going for many years, and it's going to be going for many years to come. So welcome to the series. I hope that you can get into it. And by the way, if this is perhaps the first Rendog survival video that you are watching, you've missed 387 episodes, and I'm angry with your ass. Usually what I would do is shove this piping hot baked potato between the crack of your butthole. But I'm not going to do that, because I can't expect you guys to watch so many episodes all in one go. What I would suggest you do, though, is head over to the episode 50 world tour episode of season 4. That should catch you up quite nicely. And then watch the videos from episode 50 of season 4 all the way up to this one. And you should be pretty much up to speed what's going on. I'll stick a link in the description box below for you guys also. And hopefully you guys can get caught up before the start of season number 5. Now, where are all these new people coming from? I hear some of you guys asking. Well, as I say, if you've been living under a rock for the last 7 days or so, I've got some incredible news for you, my friends. Actually, you know what? This is too exciting. I can't do anything while I tell you guys this. I'm just going to come over here, get my face up in your business, and guys, we're in Hermitcraft! We are in Hermitcraft, guys! We got invited to join Hermitcraft Season 4 a couple of weeks back. And the reason why there haven't been other videos on my channel for the last few days is because I've been playing on the Hermitcraft server pretty much all day long for the last few days, getting absolutely no sleep and trying to create as many Hermitcraft videos as I can, because I'm having so much freaking fun on that server. But we are on Hermitcraft, my friends, and not only we, our brother from a Swedish frickin' mama, Iskal85, is also in Hermitcraft season number 4. And oh my goodness, where did you come from? I haven't seen a creeper in these halls in really long, man. This is ridiculous. Get out of here, son. Oh my goodness. Okay, we're gonna have to get Argos out for this one, I think. Argos, dude, we need you. We need you. Get out of here. Okay. Whew, that was freaking close. I don't know where that creeper came from. He shouldn't be in here. Okay, well, we better sleep the night away, guys, because that is kind of concerning that a creeper spawned inside a mole in the molehole castle. Oh, man. Let my heart rest. Jeez. That kind of took the breath out of me. So yeah, guys, in the previous episode, I mentioned we had some big news, and I don't think it gets any bigger than that. We are hermits now, which is just absolutely fantastic. You know, a lot of you guys have been asking me in the comments, how does it feel to be on the Hermitcraft server? And to be honest with you guys, I don't really know what to say to that question. It's still kind of surrealistic to me, you know, waking up every morning and thinking to myself that I can log into the Hermitcraft server and play with some of the best Minecrafters on YouTube and play with some YouTubers that I myself have watched for many years and I myself have learned a lot from over the years. You know, it's absolutely ridiculous that this has happened to us, and I couldn't be more pleased for myself, and not only for myself, guys, but for us, the CyberDog Nation, because it has just been such an incredible journey for us all over the last few years. And to me, being invited to join Hermitcraft is almost like an affirmation that the work that we've been doing here is, you know, we've done good work, man. We're finally being recognized in the world, and it's really amazing. And you know, it wouldn't have been possible without you fine people out there who have been supporting me over the last few years. Just managed to pick up an Unbreaking 3 book, so that's pretty awesome. But you know, it's completely insane to me that Hermitcraft for us is now a thing. I mean, I've been playing on the Hermitcraft server now for a very long time, hour-wise, for the last week or so. It almost feels like I've been playing for months, you know? So it kind of feels like it's not really brand new for me anyway, but it's literally only been a few days. But already I feel like I'm really into the server and getting to know all of the other hermits and making some good friends all around and having an amazing time on the server. It's absolutely awesome. And I know that there's a ton of you guys who have perhaps joined us from other hermits, and I just want to welcome you to the series and welcome you to the CyberDog Nation. I hope you guys have a really awesome time here, and we're all delighted to have you on board. So yeah, that's the news, guys. Absolutely massive. Absolutely massive news. Now, off the back of that news, I've had some mixed responses from you guys. I would say 95% of you CyberDogs out there are extremely happy that we are now a hermit, but there's a number of you out there, who are a little bit worried about what's going on, and a lot of you guys who are big fans of this particular series are kind of concerned that maybe Hermitcraft is going to take over and we're not going to work on survival anymore, we're not going to work on survival stories anymore, and we're just going to do Hermitcraft from now on. And guys, I just want to talk a little bit now about that, just to let you know exactly where we sit as a CyberDog Nation, okay? The Victorian greenhouse is going through some serious pimpification right now, my friends. As you can see, it is starting to look really cool in here. Spent the last couple of hours trying to get this place into a reasonable state so that we can carry on working on it together in the videos. Now, for those of you guys who don't remember how this place works, or maybe you are new, I'm going to break it down for you exactly what is going on in here, okay? So we've got this rail line that zigzags all the way through this building. As you can see, it goes all the way through like this, and on each side of the rail line are rows of crops. Underneath these crops are sticky pistons, and the idea is that we are going to be triggering these sticky pistons as we travel along the railway line in a minecart, and as we go, those sticky pistons are going to push the crops up, and we're going to be able to collect those crops as we are traveling along. Now, we've got all of the crops that we need over here. We've got wheat, three rows of wheat actually, and then we've got two rows of potatoes over here, and then a row and a half of carrots. And then what will happen is the railway line will go up this ramp onto the second story, and that is where we are going to be collecting pumpkins, melons, and cocoa beans. And yeah, that is pretty much how it's going to work, and I just freaking wrecked this by mistake. And I think if we can pull it off and get the place looking awesome and working properly, this is going to solve all of our food needs in this series, which is absolutely awesome. All of our food needs in Mole City anyway. Now, we still have a bunch of stuff to do. What I've done is I've installed all of the sticky pistons underneath all of the crop lines, and all we need to do now is get the track laid. And I want to show you guys exactly how this is working out. because so far it is working pretty good. So if we stick our mine cart over here, get in the sucker, hit the button, we're going to go down and you can see all of the crops get pushed up and then pushed down again. And as we come around the corner, we collect them all. And I've set up the redstone in such a way that we don't miss picking up any of them. As you can see, we picked up all of the, well, most of the seeds and most of the wheat. For some reason we didn't pick these two up, but I think I still need to sort of optimize the redstone there for that. But that is what I'm talking about, my friends. That was absolutely awesome, right? I mean, how quickly did we harvest that wheat? That was absolutely insane. And hopefully it'll be able to do exactly the same all the way through. So that's basically how the Victoria greenhouse works. And we're going to spend some time now getting this place set up. It's going to be freaking awesome. Let's get these crops replanted and carry on working on getting the place sorted. A lot of work still to do in here. So the next few episodes or so, guys, we're going to be finishing off this bad boy. Now, let's talk, you and me, because I know there's a few of you out there who are very, very worried. And I want to thank you guys for your concern, for your emails and for your messages about me joining Hermitcraft and about you guys being really worried about what Hermitcraft might do to the Rendog channel, what it might do to this series in particular. And you know what, guys? I don't even get mad at you guys because... the fact that you guys are taking time out of your life to write to me about this series, to express your concerns about this series perhaps being replaced by Hermitcraft or something like that, it makes me feel amazing because it makes me feel like you guys are really passionate about this series. You really love it enough to actually write to me about your concerns. Now, I've seen a few comments on my Hermitcraft videos from you guys saying, is Hermitcraft going to replace Survival? Where is Survival? How come you haven't uploaded a Survival episode in a few days? What's going on? I can't believe this. I really like Hermitcraft, but I don't want you to stop playing Survival. Guys, chill, man. Chill, Winston. Please don't stress. The only reason that there have been a lot of Hermitcraft videos over the last few days is because it's brand new. I'm having so much fun playing Hermitcraft and I wanted to make as many videos as possible, man. I was just having so much fun on the server, just jamming and playing with all of my new friends and everything and trying to get as many videos as I could out for you guys so that you guys could come along on the journey with me. You know, the Hermitcraft server is live. By that I mean it's changing every single day and it's really important that we keep up with the changes or else we're going to get left behind. So I've just been working really, really hard to make sure that I don't miss any of the starting stuff, because that's, in my opinion, when the coolest stuff happens, is at the very beginning of a Minecraft multiplayer survival series, right? And I just wanted to make sure that we were all together for that crazy ass ride. But guys, it doesn't mean that this series is going to be replaced. In fact, it's the exact opposite. This is still my primary series on my YouTube channel, and it will be forever. This is my heart and soul right here. This Minecraft world is the reason why I am now able to sit here and tell you guys that I am pretty much living a dream come true, being invited to the Hermitcraft server, that my YouTube channel is getting to a place now where I might just be able to make this thing sustainable. And it's just absolutely incredible that it's happening. And, you know, it's you guys and it's this series and it's the world that we have created together that has helped to bring us into this position that we are now. So I don't want you guys to worry about this series. I really don't. I love this series more than anything. I really love Hermitcraft, of course. I'm absolutely loving my time there, but this series is still my favorite in the world, and it's still what I love doing most, and it's still the series that when I wake up in the morning and I think that I'm going to be playing some Minecraft Survival in this world, it makes me super, super happy, and it makes me super inspired. And that ain't going to change for a very long time, guys. We are almost at the end of Season 4, and that means we are coming up to Season 5 very soon, which is amazing. And I cannot wait to start Season 5 because we've got so many plans and so much awesome stuff to do together, and I just can't wait to get to it. Now, a few of you other guys out there have also been saying to me, all of these new series are starting on your channel, but what happens is then other series gets left behind. Why aren't you playing Hearthstone? Why aren't you playing Terraria? Why aren't you playing all of these other games that you used to play? And why aren't you playing The Witcher? What is going on? Now, let me try and explain to you guys what is happening on that side of things. Man, I keep trampling on my own damn crops over here. Now, let me just start off by saying, my friends, that I'm just a human being, okay? I don't have infinite time. I mean, if I could choose an X-Man power, right, I would choose the power to slow time down so that I could make all the videos in the world for you guys. All of the games that you guys want me to play, Euro Truck Simulator and all of that goodness, I would love to make it all. But the reality of the situation, my friends, is that at the moment, I've got to work also. I don't do YouTube full time at the moment, so I literally don't have enough hours in the day to be able to make all of the videos that I would like to make for you guys out there. It doesn't mean that I don't like the games anymore or that I don't want to do the series. It just means that I physically can't. I just physically don't have the power, Scotty. I just don't have the resource, the time resource to be able to create all of those videos. Now, you know, something like Hermitcraft and the amazing things that have been happening on my channel over the last week or so, you know, mostly because of Scrappy Racers and mostly because of Hermitcraft, means that we are getting closer to maybe being able to make this thing sustainable, my friends. Being able to, you know, make YouTube something that I could actually feel safe doing full-time, knowing that it's going to pay my bills, knowing that it's going to be able to support me, knowing that it's going to be able to one day support my family, because I would really like to have some cyber pups of my own, my friends. You know, I got to think about the future too. I got to think about 5 years from now. I got to think about 10 years from now, right? If I want to have kids, is what I'm doing now going to allow my kids to have a decent life? I want my kids to have a really, really good life, right? As good of a life as I can give them. And of course, I have to think about that stuff because unfortunately, I'm an adult now. as much as that sucks, I do have to be a little bit careful with making sure that, you know, I am looking after my life and looking after my future family too. So, all of that being said, we are getting really close to being able to make this YouTube thing that we've been working together for the last 4 years on sustainable. Maybe. I mean, it's every single day that passes, it gets a little bit closer to that goal, right? And, you know, joining Hermitcraft is an amazing opportunity for us. And, you know, I feel so incredibly privileged and honored to be able to have been invited to join the server, because what it's going to mean is potentially a life-changing situation for us, for me and for you guys also in the CyberDog Nation, because maybe, just maybe, we're going to open up our audience to a much bigger range, right? Now that we're on the Hermitcraft server, the CyberDog Nation is going to be exposed to a lot more people. This series is going to be exposed to a lot more people, and hopefully those people will enjoy it as much as you guys enjoy it, and hopefully they'll stick around for a while. There's a freaking zombie in Mole City! That golem is going crazy, man. He slapped the jazz out of that freaking zombie. Good job, Greg Clone! Nice work, my friend. Oh my goodness. Hippolyta, are you okay? Yeah, Hippolyta's okay. Let's just do a villager check, my friends. Man, freaking zombies spawning in Mole City, guys. It is scary times around here, let me tell you. Gotta sleep as that sun is going down, or our village is gonna get wrecked one day. But yeah, anyway, guys, so you know, basically what I'm saying is I know that it feels like to some of you guys that, you know, I've heard some of you guys saying that I'm selling out. I mean, I don't even know what that means. I'm not entirely sure what selling out means, but I know that maybe some of you guys feel like I'm going to drop the series or drop the other series because of Hermitcraft, but that's absolutely not the case at all. You know, Hermitcraft is going to hopefully open up a whole new world for us. It's going to open up our YouTube channel to a whole new audience, and that new audience might just bring us closer to, you know, being able to make this crazy YouTube thing a sustainable project for us. You know what, guys? You and I have been working so incredibly hard on this YouTube dream over the last few years, haven't we? It's been absolutely crazy. It's been a mental journey, especially, of course, for those of you guys who've been with me from the very beginning. And, you know, I will be the first to admit to you all that in all of this time that we've been doing YouTube, I've made some pretty good and some pretty bad decisions. I mean, that is 100% certain. But you know what, man? I'm only human, and I'm just doing the best that I absolutely can for this channel and for this community. And of course, I'm going to make some mistakes along the way, guys. But I just want you to know that every decision that I make, I make for the betterment of this channel. I make with the intention to get us to the place that we really want to be. And that is a place where I can be producing all of the content that you guys want, you know, to be on a schedule that you guys are happy with, to bring out daily videos for you guys to enjoy, and to build a CyberDog Nation and a CyberDog community that we can all be exceptionally proud of, and that we can all be a part of for many, many years to come. And, you know, the decisions that I have made for this channel have always been focused on making that a reality. And even though I have made, you know, some bad decisions along the way, I think that I've made some pretty good decisions along the way too. And I think that joining the Hermitcraft community is the best decision that we could ever make, because we are joining a group of people on YouTube that love this game and love YouTube just as much as we do. And, you know, to be able to join forces with other people who think the same and who know, you know, have a lot more knowledge than we do about YouTube and about, you know, how to make this whole thing sustainable and how to make this dream come true is an amazing opportunity for us and an amazing way for us to get to a place where I can make all the videos that you guys want. I can play Hearthstone again. I can play Terraria again, and I don't have to worry about putting food on my table or, you know, paying for the internet bill so that I can actually upload the videos and all of that sort of thing. So yeah, that's, you know, that's pretty much what I wanted to talk about, guys. And I hope that you do understand my decisions, you know, and do try and see where I'm coming from on this. And I just don't want you guys to worry so much about it. And I want you to remember that this series and the CyberDog Nation are my primary loves in this world, right? And that's where my loyalties lie, is with you guys, is with this survival series, is with the CyberDog Nation, and that's where they will always lie, because you guys are making my dream come true, man. Without you guys, there wouldn't be no Hermitcraft. Without you guys, there wouldn't be no YouTube channel. There would be nothing at all. So, you know, it's you guys that are keeping me going, and you guys that are the fuel of my freaking fire, baby. And, you know, bring on 2016, my friends. It's going to be an absolutely awesome year for us all. And it started off really, really awesome. Now, with regards to, you know, video scheduling and all of that sort of thing that you guys have been asking me about, at the moment, there is no schedule because I'm still working full time, of course. So I'm trying to record and edit videos as much as possible for you guys. And sometimes that means that, you know, the videos might be a little bit sporadic and a little bit all over the place, because I only have a few hours at night when I get home from work to record. So I need to sort of choose what I want to record. And generally what I do is record what I feel like recording. You know, I don't want to record because I'm forced to record. I want to make you guys videos that I'm enjoying doing and that you guys will enjoy watching. So sometimes I get home and I feel like making survival, or I feel like making survival stories. It just depends what I feel like in the mood, you know, what I'm in the mood for. But what I can tell you is that there will be a lot of Hermitcraft videos coming out over the next few months or so. Hopefully, you know, 3 to 5 a week. I hope so. And what I'm going to try and do is up the number of videos from the survival series 2, and of course from the survival stories 3 series 2. So I'm going to try and sort of increase my video production for you guys as much as possible. And as I mentioned in the previous episode, I'm looking to move out of London and move to my own hermit hole somewhere where I can literally focus on generating content for you guys full time. And hopefully that's going to get us even closer to the dream of being able to make this whole thing a sustainable system for us. And that's the plan, my friends, and I hope that sort of makes sense to you. And you know, please leave your feedback in the comments below, guys. Well, my friends, it feels like I have been talking for about a year now. I hope I didn't ramble too much in this episode, but yeah, we did get quite a lot done, managed to get some of the rails done. In the next episode, we're going to work on the redstone for this Victorian greenhouse and get this sucker up and running. I did want to spend today though talking to you guys about Hermitcraft and about the future of the Rendog channel, and I hope you guys could understand what I was saying, and I hope you guys will support me through this crazy journey, because I need you guys, man. I freaking need you to help me out and to be there behind me. You are my wings, my friends, and let's do this together, okay? Anyway, thank you so much for watching, my friends. I hope you have enjoyed it, and I cannot wait to see you in the next episode of Minecraft Survival. I'm Ren Dog. I'm a sign out, and we will see you in the next episode.